All right, so weather like this, everybody focuses on the basics, which they should. Food, water, shelter, fire. When snow on the ground coming down, everybody's worried about getting shelter, getting that fire started before the sun goes down, and that's good. But the one thing that we often overlook is dehydration. You have to drink water. I have seen guys go down from dehydration doing cross-country skiing. You have to still gather properly and properly treat water. All right, so you always want to find the cleanest source of water that you can find. In this case, I've got a nice flowing river. It's got ice starting to form around the edges, but it, for the most part, it's fairly clean water. I don't want to just go filling up my canteens because I'm tired, I'm run down, the snow's coming down, I know I need to get a fire. I still have to have the presence of mind that I can't just be drinking this stuff. I can't take the chance of getting sick. All right, so I have to treat water before I go putting it into my water receptacles. All right, so we're gonna first take another container. In this case, I like using this little collapsible bucket I have. I can actually dip this stuff down in the water. All right, now that's enough water to fill both my bottles. I'm here to tell you though, that's not the cleanest stuff. Not sure I wanna drink that the way it is right now. All right, so the snow has let up on us a little bit, and we've acquired our water from our water source, our nice little creek, and we're gonna go about purifying it now. All right, so when you start talking about chemical treatment, there's all different kinds of techniques to do. There's all different kinds of products on the market. Some have pros, some have cons. What's the difference? Which one do you wanna carry? Well, you can just buy what's on the shelf, but again, knowledge is power. Try them out, you know, figure out what's best for your mission. The first one I want to talk about is the old reliable iodine tablets. These things have been around forever. I grew up with them in the Army. A small little bottle you keep in your pack lasts you forever, right? But very, very small tablets. Depending on how clean or cold the water is, you want to put one or two tablets in it. We're going to do just one. It's water out of our creek. It may look a little cloudy, but it's not bad. Drop it in. Now you're going to wait about 3 minutes. You're going to wait about 5 minutes. Let it dissolve. Now you notice I'm leaving the caps on loose. Now after I wait 5 minutes, I'm then going to shake it a little bit. I let some of the water come out. It covers the threads on the bottle, and then I'm gonna let it sit for 30 minutes. That iodine now is going to kill everything that's in there. Works great, has worked great forever. The only disadvantage of this is, well, now my water tastes like iodine. Not too bad, but lots of drinking of water with iodine, it's just not a good taste. It's really not. So, fast forward, right? Now, Potable Aqua has got a new product, been out for a while, but if you haven't seen it before, it has two bottles. You'll see I tape them together, that way I can't lose them in my pack, right? And the first bottle, the one up top, is it's your regular bottle of iodine. You use it the same way as I did this other one. One tablet goes in there, you've got to wait 30 minutes. Still have to wait 30 minutes. However, once I've waited the 30 minutes and this is now clean drinking water, I turn it over, I take a tablet from my other bottle. If you use two tablets, put two in, but I only use one iodine. I'm going to use one of these. Now, this PA++ tablet, all it does is it neutralizes the taste of that iodine. Now, I've waited the 30 minutes. My water is clear, ready to drink, but it tastes like iodine. By adding that other tablet, all I've got to do is just kind of let it dissolve for a while. 3 minutes later, the tablet doesn't even have to fully dissolve. I wait about 3 minutes, I can now drink this water. It doesn't have the taste of iodine in it anymore. So good product, good stuff. But again, you treating with this, it does not get out the heavy metals, does not get out any of the chemicals that are in the water. All right, so another chemical treating process that a lot of people talk about is using your normal chlorine bleach, that Clorox that you have in your house. Yeah, again, pros and cons. If you're gonna use chlorine bleach, make sure that it's regular unscented. Right? The formula that you want to use is 2 drops per quart of water or 6 drops of bleach per gallon of water. That's fine, but personally, I'm not going to walk around through the woods carrying a big old bottle of bleach, number one. Number two, if that bleach has been sitting in the laundry room for 6 months, it's about half its normal strength. Now I'm having to put 12 drops of bleach into a gallon of water, and it's going to taste like I'm drinking out of a swimming pool. Not a big fan of it, but if you're going to do it, find a smaller container, whether like I use these little eyedropper bottles, but even filling a small container like this with bleach, it's still a rough chemical. It's hard to transport. You can't fly with it. It always seems to leak everywhere. It's just not fun to use. But if that's all you have is bleach, again, 2 drops per quart, you've got to let it sit for 30 minutes. But after that, it's okay to use. But again, not a big fan of it. Another way to do it is with a chemical called chlorine dioxide. Now, it's available in tablets and drops. Chlorine dioxide is awesome because you don't get the taste of the bleach. Right? They actually add chlorine dioxide to chlorine water to get rid of the taste of the chlorine. It's great stuff. I mentioned it's available in tablets and drops. These are the Aquamira tablets. They're roughly the same size as those little iodine tablets. They're individually sealed, so if you want to just take a few of them to toss wherever, they're good to do. Small little tablet. A little bit larger than an iodine tablet. All right, now you take 1 per liter of water. Drop it in. Just that easy. All right, the disadvantage of this is for these tablets, I have to wait 4 hours. Now, there's no bleach taste at all. There's no iodine taste, but I have to wait 4 hours. Now, if I've just been hiking through the mountains, I finally get to that stream and, oh, I'm thirsty. I haven't had water for a while. I fill up my bottles, I've dropped my tablets, and now I have to wait 4 more hours. I don't want to wait. No, I don't. I want something that I can use right now, or at least within 15 minutes, 30 minutes. So while these are great for travel, for an emergency situation, for everyday use, the tablets just aren't the thing for me. Now, same company, they have another product of chlorine dioxide, except it's in drops. Works roughly the same way, except all you do is you take, it comes with a little cap, and you pour 8 drops from part A. Eight drops from part B. You just swish that around a little bit. All right, you're gonna wait 5 minutes for this all to mix properly, and then you're gonna add it, pour it into a quart of water, and you're gonna have the same strength of chlorine dioxide, except now I only have to wait 15 minutes instead of having to wait 4 hours for the tablet. So it mixes much, much quicker. So again, chlorine dioxide kills everything. It's great. The drops work fast. You don't get the taste of chlorine. You don't get the taste of the iodine. But again, it does not get out heavy metals, does not get out chemicals. Right, so that's a great technique. Personally, I like the chlorine dioxide drops. All right, so we've been dealing with fairly clean water that we got out of our creek back here. But what about if we didn't have a good clean source? Trust me, that may not look clean. It's pretty clean. How about if you had like nasty, cruddy water that you, like all that you could find was like a tire track out in the middle of nowhere. If you've got nasty, cruddy water like this I dug up off the bottom of the side little pool over here, you can just see the nasty stuff just floating around in this thing. Iodine tablet or chlorine tablet, I ain't putting that in me. I'm not doing it. So how do we get around it? The military's got a new product that they're using that's called Chlor-Flox. Been around for a while. I actually use Chlor-Flox. to treat a couple canteens that I filled out of a tire track in Africa. It was some nasty water. Didn't really need to do it, kind of wanted to put it to the test, and I'll tell you what, works great. Easy to do. We take our container with our nasty water. Again, try to get the cleanest water you have, but if this is all you've got, Chlor-Flox works awesome on it. All right, so you're going to take one of these little sachets. Different models, it comes also in tablets, but the one that the military is currently issuing, it comes in little sachets. Comes in a nice little camouflage bag with a zipper on top. Toss it in your kit, doesn't make any noise, doesn't weigh anything. But this is a single dose sachet, right? The water is really, really nasty. You'd put in two of these, but one or two, but at a minimum, one whole sachet. So open it up, all you do is you dump it in. I'm gonna open this other one up. I think we're gonna rock two on this thing. It's looking pretty funky. Same thing, gonna pour it in. All right, so I've got two in there. Now all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna shake it up for 1 minute to dissolve. Now, the whole point of Chlor-Flox is it's gonna use the chlorine dioxide to kill everything that's in it, but it's also got the flox in it that's gonna coagulate all this sediment, all this organic material, right? So I shake it up real good. And now I'm gonna let that sit for 3 minutes. All right, so we've weighed out our 3 minutes. You can already see it's starting to separate. All right, what we're gonna do is we're gonna swirl it around for 30 seconds. Now I know I'm mixing it all back together, that's fine, but what I'm doing is I'm allowing all the chemicals to touch the top and the sides of the container that weren't being touched before. So we're gonna do this for 30 seconds. Getting all the stuff off the sides. All right, after our 30 seconds is up, now we're gonna sit it down. Warm weather, just let it sit for 7 minutes. But because it's a little cold out here, we're gonna wait the full 15 minutes recommended. All right, so we've waited our 15 minutes. You can see, well, this water was cruddy. It has separated most of the organic material down to the bottom. Some of the really light stuff, when I was scooping, I was getting stuff off the top of the water also. So some of it was still floating. Some of it, that's just some nasty stuff at the bottom. There's still some particulate matter that's floating in the middle here. All right, the next step is you're gonna take a clean container. In this case, I'll take my wide mouth Nalgene bottle. And you have to strain this. Now, manufacturer recommends flannel. When are you ever gonna have flannel with you? Guys, you can get by with just a t-shirt. Put a t-shirt over it, over my bottle. And then all I'm gonna do is pour this through. And I don't know if you can see it sloshing, but it's like been gelled inside there, all right? Pour it slow. Now, when it starts overflowing the top of your t-shirt, the mouth, that means you've literally caught so much of that snot on your t-shirt that you've clogged all the pores. Piece of cake, move to a new clean piece of t-shirt. Now obviously, would you use water this dirty? No, always use the cleanest water source that you have available. But if this is all you've got is nasty water that you would never ever think about putting in your body, I'm here to tell you this is gonna get it as clean as possible. This stuff is pouring out like jello syrup. actually more like the morning after at a frat party after too much tequila. Not that I've ever drank that much. All right, so you get the idea that, well, not 100% clear, that is light years above what we started at before. That's actually pretty good. All right, another water purification method that I hear about is calcium hypochlorite. People talk about in a survival situation, you've got to have tons of pool shock for cleaning water. And don't get me wrong, it's awesome for at your house for purifying water long-term. A pound of, you know, this 1 pound bag of pool shock, it'll clean 3,000 gallons of water. It works awesome. It really does, but for walking around in the woods, for traveling, no, not so much, and here's why. It's chlorine. It cleans the same way as using the bleach does. This will keep forever, so in your house, it works so much better than storing gallons of bleach. Yes, but for traveling, not so much. All right, so step one, all right, you're gonna take, you need to make a stock treating liquid first, and you do that by taking a teaspoon of this stuff. All right, and you're gonna take it and you pour that into 2 gallons of water. Now, that doesn't make 2 gallons of water that you can drink. What that makes is 2 gallons of water that you can then treat other water with. All right, so what you're wanting to do is you want one part of that liquid for 100 parts of water being treated. So what does that mean? What that means is if I'm trying to make clean drinking water from my house, I then take 1 cup of that 2 gallon solution and I dump it into 100 cups of regular untreated water. That will give me 101 cups of now potable water for my family to use at my house. That's fine, but it doesn't break down into an equation that you could use for a normal 1 quart container. You can't say, well, I'm gonna take 1 granule of this stuff and drop it in a quart of water and expect it to work. The math just doesn't work that well, right? So for long-term storage, pool shock is great. For treating large amounts of water at a household or a small village complex, it works great. But for traveling around, for hiking, for backpacking, pool shock's just not the way to go. Stick with one of the other proven methods. So anyways, that's all the different ways that you can purify water. We talked about all of them, everything from boiling water all the way down to using the UV light. They all have pros, they all have cons. Determine what your individual mission is, and then just remember, knowledge is power. Try the different types out. See, maybe you like the taste of one better than the other. Maybe you don't like waiting 4 hours. You only want to wait 15 minutes. Weigh the pros and cons, find out what works best for you, and then always plan backups, right? Filter and UV, filter and tablets. Try them both, try the different ways, figure out what works both for you. And don't forget to check out my website, tacticalrifleman.com. And make comments. If you have any questions, I'll be sure to get back to you right away. Also, suggestions for other videos. All right, that is how to purify water.